presentation about sand. We are going to compare Pulsar Zand, close to Amersfoort, to Australia on the other side of the world.
We are also going to compare
plants and animals.
I see you later.
Welcome at Pulsar Zand!
Welcome everybody to Pulsar Zand.
As you can see, it's almost all sand.
Wow, it's beautiful, isn't it?
So, in this envelope, we've got animals that live in the Australian desert and that live here on Hulsa Chisholm. So, I'm going to show you some of the animals
that
live in the Australian desert. This is the Perenti. It's like a large lizard. This is the thorny devil. As you can see, well, it's not very clear, that has sort of thorns all over it. This is the bilby. It's a sort of mouse, but then bigger. And this is, of course, what Australia is famous about, the red kangaroo. Animals that that live in the Australian desert. This is the desert dingo. It looks, well, a lot like a dog. And this is the bearded dragon. It's called the bearded dragon because it looks like he's got a beard. And here is one of the rare lizards that live in Hulsa Zand. It's called the levensbarende hagedis. So you don't see it very often.
These are three examples of the trees in the Australian desert. This is the eucalyptus tree. It's a quite big tree. And it's nowadays it's used for if you have a cold. This is the gums tree. No, not the chewing gum, but the gums tree. Okay. And this is the acacia tree. That's one of the most common trees in the Australian desert.
This is Roodbeker moss. You can see it at Hulshorster Sand, but we haven't seen it yet.
These are two examples of plants in the Australian desert. This is the Australian salt marsh. It's also called the old man plant. Yeah. And this is the prickly mosses, because it's really prickly. Let's see if we can find other plants.
I think so.
Find out more of these about these mushrooms at home.
Look, colorful grass.
How deep is this grass roots?
Yeah, come on, you can do this. You can do this.
Now that's a big clump of roots.
Whoa!
That tree